grandmother, Grace Bandawe. Their golden wedding, 1963. I was able to study and get myself a scholarship to come to UK to study automobile engineering, which was influenced by my father, who was an engineer in the police, and a great footballer who died in a football accident in 1954. And hence, my sport accolades tend to connect myself to my father, who I never saw when I was four years old. I found myself very much interested in basketball because my mom stopped me playing football, because she had bad memories of the experience of losing my dad. Then I took up basketball through the American Peace Corps volunteers, who came after the country became independent in 1964. And thereafter, basketball became a strong part of me in sport. And later on, I had a chance to go for a scholarship, which I managed to get a scholarship through the British Council. And there I found myself really doing well as a motor vehicle mechanic, and I lectured at Lilongwe Technical College in Malawi, as well as worked as a part-time lecturer at Kitson College in Leeds. I soon wanted to get back to something that really made me happy, and that was basketball. I developed a youth basketball club called the Leeds Tigers, and the Leeds Tigers has been a very successful basketball club in England, produced a lot of international players. I could say 25 England internationals, and five players ended up in American University. I have been involved with Swino Primary School, and my interest has been very much basketball. I have a youth basketball club there. It's a primary school, which is mini basketball, and those kids are playing basketball now. The head of Swino, Alison Chin, was very much interested how I was doing how I was dealing with the young people at the school. And later on, she asked me if at all I could discuss something about black history. And then with the black history, I found myself showing her a book which my grandfather had written, The Memoirs of a Malawian. And it was very interesting because this book has much links with the David Livingstone missionaries, which really made me feel good. So I thought I might as well as talk about my grandfather. So I told them about my grandfather's link with the David Livingstone missionaries, and they were very interested. Then I told them I was going to Malawi. I went to Malawi to see my family. I took some pictures of some schools, and there I found out that poverty was really epidemic. Kids were sat on the floor writing, using their knee as a desk, which was very, very touching. It reminded me of my early days when I was a kid in Malawi. But this was worse than my time, because during the colonial days, things were much stable than this time. I brought some pictures to the school, and I showed the school, as well as everybody was just shocked. And they said they were going to do something. That was the beginning of the Swino Namiwawa project, which I'm involved at the meantime, to raise money to buy desks to stop kids sitting on the floor. So I went to Malawi recently, and I bought some desks, 35 desks, just for one room.
We shall live on.
Do you like your school? My bonda school. Oh. Amaziwa masamu ndani. Chabuno, ino. Sika ika imani. Imozi, okay. Ino. Yeah. One in the jan. Two. All right. Sika ni fancy. Is this all you have? Is this the smallest
school? No, for days. Some of them are on holiday. You see, I think they are on the hospital with this money. They are waiting for the parents to be paid.
Is it because when they haven't got money, it's very hard to get to school?
You see, they are sent home, so I think the mothers are waiting for the money to end so that they can send the children to come back instead.
Is the main problem transport for the kids to come to school?
Most of when you ask them, when they come, they answer like that, we're waiting for the man to pay the money to make sure that we send the children transport money.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. What problems do you face as regards to progress? If they miss school, how do you deal with that? Because others would have been in front and others would be more or less lagging behind. How do you manage to deal with that? Mabanga Bwanji, I also was many map on this Thursday. And then my car, special class, I've been on my pastor homework.
They are given sometimes homework. And you can give them special class because it will be possible since they're supposed to open with their friends.
Yes, okay.
And you can't advise for the whole class. For example, we have made this. Then when they come, we have to go back to this instead of going forward, then we are not going to finish this class.
Okay. Yeah. Anyway, thank you very much.
Then I begin with letter G.
I want J.
a very, very big club. Oh, thank you very much. How are you? I'm all right. I'm very pleased to see a very big class. It's just, the room is very small. Don't you think so?
Yes. Very small.
Oh, thank you. So school uniform is the reason why most of them did not come.
No, we announced that they should have
had,
the others did. Then maybe
they're just afraid. Okay. Do they have to, who makes the school uniforms?
The parents
have got to make it themselves.
Yes.
Okay. I thought maybe
that is for the other parents to buy a uniform.
Yes.
They cannot afford to buy it.
They are ashamed of themselves.
Yeah.
How much is a uniform? Roughly.
Approximately maybe 1,000.
1,000 kwacha. Okay. So if at all there was a chance of uniform, then there will be more kids will be able to come to school.
Yes. Yesterday they were told to put on uniform. They are afraid to come today.
Okay. All right. Okay.
Thank you. Yes, I will.
Appreciation to Swino primary school.
Guest of honor, Mr. Bandawe, our representative from education, the fair for Shomoni Zone, Mr. Taiga, the chair of the school management committee, Mr. Jinkota, the chair of the PTA, Mr. Gatsabola, the vice chair of the PTA, Mrs. Maridadi, the president of Health and Nutrition, Mr. Kalamula.
Zikavuta tisa kamba chizungu pangono. Ndiye tisa kamba chizungu pangono. Ziko mkwambili anyamata ndi asika, na? Ndakondula kwambili kuti mwasonkana hapa. Inesu njiru okondwa. Chifuacha kuti ulendo huu. Unali ulendo wakuti tizambe kutandiza napo hapa hapo. Ndiye anzano haku sukuru yaku swino. Ndiye amene haku kutandiza ninuyo. Akuyamba kugula madesiki. Kuti mukhale nao madesiki aja. Kuti muzikali ya pansi. Ulendo weyamba nina bwela kuno. Napiza anyamata hata kala pansi chonji kumane basu kuuje ma zintu pa, pa uje pa pa. Apate? Yeso pano, njita onesa anzanu mko ku England, ana chimozi mozi chonchi, a headmaster ana ziziteka, tipange po gantu, ana ose ajanati ife tipanga gantu, ndi anamba kuma chita masewera, mitundu mitundu, kuti azi apeze ndala maza kuti atandize kukula mazintuzi. Nde kuyamba kuyamba ndikumene kutamba ngako kwa kuti kusogoloko muzakhala nonse ndi madesk kuno bwino zinthu zina zizabwera zizapita pa sogolo. I'm very pleased to see you today because the school from England, Swino, is very much interested in you. I showed them pictures while some of you were sat on the floor writing using your knee as a desk. And they said, we are going to do something about it. And they started raising money. And when I said I was coming to Malawi to visit my family, they said, please, go and buy desks for one class only. And what we have done, I engaged some of the members of staff here with me. We went to the factory where the desks are manufactured, and today I'm very, very, very pleased and very humbled indeed. This gives me great pleasure. Thanks God I'm alive.
See us now, sitting on the day, see us now, sitting on the day, see us now, sitting on the day, this
thank you for their precious gift to give us. Thank you for their precious gift. Thank you for their precious gift to give us. Thank you for their precious gift. See us now.
Our thanks to the primary school in England which is known as Swino Primary School, that we appreciate their gesture, which they have just shown to us, Namiwawa Primary School. And we are also appealing to our fellow stakeholders that they should emulate the spirit which has been rendered by Swino Primary School. Thank you very much.
I'm very touched by the response which you have shown. Very much appreciated in many, many ways. And I believe that this message speaks for itself. I didn't tell you what to do. It came from your heart, how you felt about the little help that has started dripping in from the UK. This will definitely be passed to Swino, and I will vigorously make a lot of speeches in the UK. I'll try to write a lot of letters to a lot of philanthropists in the UK who are interested to helping underprivileged people like yourself. I'm not looking down upon you. I was once like you. But I want to reach out my hand and say, please, it shouldn't be like this. There can be a change. That's the change I'm looking for. And I would like that to happen. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thing today is to try and see if at all I can rally support from any philanthropists out there who might be willing to make a difference to these young people in Malawi.